This is about the time when you might say, what does this have to do with computer vision?
What does this have to do with vision?
I'm so glad you asked. All right. Well, another way of phrasing what we've been doing is, given some sequence of observations, which model was most likely to have generated those? So using our previous clothing and weather example, so suppose you're seeing some sequence of clothing, right? So you check the clothing that people are wearing each day, and you see this coat, whatever. And then the question you want to ask is this Philadelphia, Boston, or Newark? The idea is that presumably what you've been doing is you've been collecting sequences of these observations from Philadelphia, a bunch of them from Boston, a bunch of them from Newark. You have trained a model, and we'll talk about that later. You've created a model that will tend to generate sequences like you see in Philadelphia or in Boston or Newark with the same statistics that they have. And then given some new observation sequence, you'd like to say, you know, which one is this? Now, notice that if we were checking Boston versus Arizona, you basically wouldn't need the sequence. It doesn't rain in Arizona for the most part. And you could say, well, do I see umbrellas? Okay. And since it's always lousy weather in Boston, I live there. If you see bathing suits, you know it's actually Cape Cod. So the idea is, you know, just from the individual elements themselves, you could determine whether it was Boston or Arizona. The whole idea of representing the time series is that there's something about the sequentiality that matters. It's the statistics of one thing following another that is indicative of the actual class. And what you're doing is you're building some models of those time series so you can then, given some observation sequence, you can say which one's most likely. And what we're going to do is we're going to apply that to computer vision.